I'm Warren Leon, and I'm Executive Director of the Clean Energy States Alliance. Solar can provide potentially very great benefits to low-income communities and low-income households, but there are a lot of challenges in getting there. The main one is that solar costs a lot of money up front, but then you save money over time. And for the person who can't afford the upfront cost, it's hard for them to install a system. State policymakers face quite a few challenges in designing effective programs for low-income communities. One, they have to come up with policies that overcome the issue that many low-income residents are renters, so they don't control their own roofs. They have to deal with the fact that you don't want to put someone with a low income at financial risk. Even if there is a 90% chance that the user of solar will benefit from it and save money, and there's a 10% chance that they won't, that's not good odds for someone who's living paycheck to paycheck and can't have even a small temporary downturn in their financial position. So states have to figure out, how do you guarantee that from day one, a low-income resident will be benefiting from solar and there'll be no chance at all that they will have higher costs because of wanting to participate in the solar economy? The opportunity for reaching low-income residents with solar has greatly expanded in the past few years. Part of it is that solar companies, state governments, other community organizations have all made solar a bigger priority than it was before, and they focused on the low-income market. But on top of that, last year, through the Inflation Reduction Act, a program was announced, the Solar for All program through the Environmental Protection Agency, and that program is providing $7 billion to advance low-income solar across the country. That's going to be truly transformative. Nothing like that's ever happened before. And now there should be much greater opportunities as long as we take advantage of the opportunity well. It's really crucial for state energy agencies to work closely and collaboratively with community organizations when trying to advance solar in low-income communities. Those community organizations really understand the needs, the opinions, and the perspectives of their residents, and they could help guide state policymakers to effective programs that actually will reach the intended audience and will meet their needs. There's a lot of distrust in low-income communities, distrust towards utilities, distrust towards government officials, and distrust towards big business. And a lot of that distrust has been well earned because low-income communities have been targeted by predatory practices for many years. And so you need to overcome that distrust. You need to have some organization that's trusted in the community that can speak for community residents, and that community residents are going to feel, yes, this really makes sense for me to listen to this person and take their advice.